My name is Simon Glendinning, and I'm the reader in European philosophy here at the European Institute at the LSE. The European Institute is a multidisciplinary department here and has faculty who teach in all sorts of areas from economics and political economy, political science, philosophy, history, law, and so on. But the structure of the Institute is quite clear. We have three master's programmes, which can be compared in some ways to an advanced variation of a very famous course taught originally in Oxford called PPE, Philosophy, Politics and Economics. Now at the European Institute we have these three degrees, one looking at mainly politics of the European Union, which asks how Europe works, a course in political economy, which is really asking why it works the way it works. And thirdly, the course I want to say something about, the European Studies, Ideas and Identities course, which asks really what Europe is. This master's programme covers a wide number of themes, but central to it is an understanding of Europe's historical trajectory and the standard way of understanding that. The usual way in which people understand the history of Europe is as it arising from a sort of Greek origin in antiquity through Rome, Christendom, and the Enlightenment. This heritage doesn't only belong to Europe's past, but forms its present. And we'll be looking at a number of crucial themes through the lens of that history. We'll be looking at Europe's multiculturalism, the rise of secularism, what some people call the revival of religion, issues around problems of minorities and migration. Now, our programme offers a wide number of courses where you can specialise in areas that have an interest for you, but the course is also open to dimensions of the European Institute outside the core stream of the Identities programme. So you might arrive as a strongly humanities student or a social science student, and you can continue to develop your knowledge and understanding of Europe outside the range of your original areas of specialism. So if you were, for example, a humanities student, you can come and you can take courses in social sciences in their investigations of Europe and build a very rich repertoire of insights and understandings about Europe today. So whether your background is in classics or philosophy or history or economics, you can come to the LSE, take the degree in European Studies, Ideas and Identities, and leave with a well-rounded vision of Europe's contemporary position and its place in the world today.